So deliberate creating requires deliberate thought, and deliberate thought requires a sensitivity to the way you feel. And a sensitivity to the way you feel requires understanding what your emotions mean. And so we can put it to you really, really simply. When you ask for something, which we call step one, contrast causes you to do that. Step two happens, which source becomes a vibrational match to what you're asking for. When you ask for more money or for a relationship or for an improved anything, your inner being becomes the vibrational equivalent of it. When you ask, it is answered. But it is answered in a vibrational frequency, that has a point of attraction that begins to attract the cooperative components. But unless you are in the same vibrational frequency, you're not privy to, you're not aware of, you're not part of, not quite yet, the awareness of the attraction of all of these cooperative components. So for a while, in order to get you to understand this vibrational world that we are wanting you to understand completely, we explained about step one, you got that. We explained about step two, it's answered. You didn't really get that because you couldn't understand why, if it was answered, why you couldn't see it yet. So we began to describe to you that it's happening, it's being answered in a vibrational realm, and you don't like that because it sounds like smoke and mirrors. It sounds like we're just trying to trick you into believing that you're getting what you want, even though you can't from your own resources see it. But we want you to understand that vibration precedes the manifestation. And once enough vibration is amassed, then it gets big enough and big enough and big enough that eventually you may begin to translate it through your own physical senses. So there's this vibrational reality that has amassed. It's so important that you believe in this vibrational reality. We gave it a name. We call it the vortex. The vortex of attraction is this swirly mass of energy that is bringing to it all things that you have asked for. Wrote a whole book about it, so you'd think it was real. And you began to sort of take our word for it a little bit, but we began to hear you say things like, all right, Abraham, you've talked about this vortex. Esther's pointing her arms at this invisible stuff over here, and your voice gets louder and louder and happier as you talk about this vortex of creation where everything you want is. Just tell me, how do I get my stuff out of the vortex and into the bank? How do I get it out here where I can see it? And then for a while, we said, go in there. Go in there where it is. Go in there where it is. Well, you just kind of freaked out over that. You made imaginary doorways and walked through them. I'm in the vortex, you said. But none of you really believed the vortex, even though it is real. And we get it. You want to see it and hear it and smell it and taste it and touch it. You want to prove it through your own experience. And we want you to, too. In fact, that's why you're here in these physical bodies. You came to be on the leading edge where thoughts do turn to things. You came to materialize ideas. Your earth was once a swirling mass of vortexual stuff that you couldn't see. And now it's something that scientists see and understand and measure. So much that was once only a thought is a physical reality. That's what this is all about here. This time-space reality where you are the genius creators who now turn more thoughts to more things.